I can't believe that we are sentenced to 80 years in prison. This is totally not fair. What were we thinking about celebrating his death?
I know, babe. 80 years is way too long, and we won't live that long here. And now we are crying because Boris and Doris are executed after their punishment day, and for what they did to Caillou, which is our grandson.
Caillou, what are you doing here in our prison cell, and why do you want to visit us in jail?
Are you going to return to us, to not abuse you anymore? We promise that we will treat you with respect, dignity and mercy.
What hypocrites who do not know what they are saying. Also, your grandson will be part of my care, and will not be abused ever again.
And your grandson would like to say something to you.
Tell us, Caillou, what is it that you want to say to us?
I want the both of you to listen to me, and listen very good. I've been suffering from the past years, days, being grounded, and being abused for everything I did. I tried to have fun, but you guys decide to ruin all the fun by my birthday for my punishment day on my birthday. Do you realize that celebrating my death is very awful, and you have to do that? What kind of grandparents are you? You just hated me for everything I do, for mistakes. You destroyed my laptop with guns, burned down my room with gasoline, and worse, you killed me and my family in the middle of Christmas with a fake present.
What you have done is called murder. You can't even threaten a child with a gun. What the hell is wrong with you people?
My husband is right. You don't deserve a grandson, after you have abused him and helped his parents with his birthday punishment day.
I really thought I was going to get another punishment day. Luckily, the police have saved me from my abusive psychopath parents. So it's time for me to stand up against you, and I will never see you again.
What? Caillou, you can't do that. I know we celebrate your death and help your parents with your birthday punishment day.
We have to do it, because we want you to learn your lessons and your mistakes. I don't want you to make bad decisions as you grow older. We are terribly sorry.
We are just doing the best as we can so that way you can be successful as an adult.
It may not seem like it, but we love you very much as your grandson.
What? You love me? What the hell? You code me. That is another freaking lie. If you would have loved me so much, you wouldn't have helped my parents with my birthday punishment day and celebrated my death. You shouldn't have thought about it way more sooner. And it's already too late. You have done enough. Your apology is denied. I don't want you to be my grandparents no more.
I'm fed up with your behavior. From today, I'm going to live with my foster family for the rest of my life.
Now if you'll excuse us, you can kiss our cheeks goodbye.
No, what have we done? We shouldn't have helped his parents for his birthday punishment day.
I know, right? I totally regret from doing this plan. And now look, our grandson, he now hate us for good. We didn't realize it was illegal.
Please let me out, please let me out, please let me out. Please let me out, please let me out. I don't want to be stuck with my new family. I prefer living with my biological parents. I blame for my stupid brother for getting our parents executed.
Rosie, your new foster parents would like to meet you.
Oh my god, not my new family. I want my biological parents back right now. Hello? And what can I help you with? And why do you want to visit me?
Oh, don't give us that excuse. You know exactly why we're here. We're here because we have to tell you the information that will be your new family.
You always have been a bad girl to your biological brother for over 2 years. We always discipline our kids, and you're the next person that will be disciplined.
I will go first to give you the spanking with my rope. Get ready.
No, 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 no.
Ow!
Look, this isn't my fault. My parents are good and innocent to giving me rewards, because he deserves to have a punishment day for destroying my dollhouse.
You idiot. Your parents are not innocent. They commit a huge crime against your biological brother. We are your new family because we can raise children better than your unqualified psychopath parents. What you did to your biological brother is unacceptable.
But I want my biological parents back. Please, I don't want to live with you.
I don't think so. They're dead. You can't go back with them.
Your biological brother had the worst birthday. What is wrong with you? He doesn't deserve to be abused.
But I think he's a troublemaker.
Stop lying. You're getting another spanking.
You're gonna pay for what you've done to your biological brother.
See you tomorrow when you get to your new home, and we have gotten permission that you will be attending juvenile detention school until you're 18.
We must get going now. See you later.
Wow. I guess Rosie's new foster family are very angry at her.
This is ridiculous. We are sentenced for the rest of our lives for committing murder and assault. Why can they not arrest that bald brat?
I know. He was the one that caused all of the drama and mess, and we got framed by that troublemaker.
Mario and Luigi, you have one visitor that wants to meet you.
Oh, it's Princess Peach. Don't worry, brother. We'll try everything to convince her to let us out. You have my back.
Thanks, brother. I don't know what I'll do without you.
Hey, Princess Peach. It seems that you have made it on time. So, is there anything that you want to say?
Yes. And this is the last time that you will meet me, 'cause I'm going back to the Mushroom Kingdom. So you better listen carefully. I don't want to do this, but I have to. I am super extremely furious of what you have done to Caillou, and torturing is not solving the situation, and I thought you were going to help him, but you didn't care. Inner heroes do not kill people, they are supposed to help and solve the situation, not murdering and assault. What is wrong with you?
Just because you hate him, doesn't mean that you should treat him like a punching bag. He is a human being that has autism and disabilities because of his abusive parents.
He had the worst birthday. Now look what you two done. You are in jail for the rest of your life, and I had lost all of my trust on you. You two completely change into a bad person and villains. What do you have to say to yourself?
Look, we just want him to improve his behavior and learn his lessons, that's all. I believe we shouldn't have done it.
Well, it's too late. You committed a huge crime and get away with it. You shouldn't have told me about what was happening. Caillou was very furious at you for what you two did.
Therefore, his parents were executed and got a punishment day before you two got arrested. They were executed like 5 days ago.
His parents were executed? We didn't notice it, but why on earth would everyone in Mexico City help Caillou with his parent punishment day?
Because it was part of his revenge and payback. It's a good thing that they are executed, and he will never be abused ever again.
Princess Peach, we are very sorry for what we have done to Caillou on his birthday. We will take responsibility and fix everything.
My brother is right. We will try everything to get this situation solved. Can we just forget what happened and go back home?
No, absolutely you may not. I had enough of you too. You are no longer part of my heroes no more. And you're kicked out of the Mushroom Kingdom forever. I'm done talking to you too. I'm out of here, and you will never see me again. Goodbye.
We are kicked out? This means...
I can't believe this had to happen. We lost our jobs and sent us for 25 years, for what we did to our former student Caillou.
I know. This is really not fair. I've been working as the principal for years, and you've been working as the teacher for years, and it's all of Caillou's fault for all of that. He should be the one who should be arrested for life, or face execution.
I know. They arrested us for what we did, when Caillou commit a lot of crimes. That's unfair. What kind of people are they to arrest us for false reasons? That is very unacceptable.
I agree with you, Miss Martin. That is so totally out of order.
Miss Clementine and Miss Martin, you have some visitors that want to see you.
I know who my two visitors are. Hi, babe, and my son Billy. This isn't what it looks like. I swear.
We believe that this isn't what it looks like. Mom, we are furious at you right now.
Yeah. We just heard from the Mexico City Police Department, from all the way to Mexico City, that you were charged and arrested for child abuse, abuse of power, allowed child abuse at your school, and even worse, you abuse one of your students named Caillou Anderson, by helping his parents with his birthday punishment day.
Along with one of your teacher staff, who is right next to you.
three of your students, including Caleb Graham Harris, and our daughter. What the hell is wrong with you? Our daughter is far too young to have a gun, and it's very illegal.
Do you realize what you did is child abuse? You beat him up with spike bats, push him down by a tall building, destroy his room with gasoline and a gun, force him to kill Chuck E. Cheese's, and worst of all, you and your staff next to you, cut his eyes off with a knife.
Have you gone insane? People can't see without their eyes. What you did is called murder.
I agree with Billy. We had to come all the way from Go City, all the way to Mexico City, to discourage you for what you did. Look what you did. You are in prison for 25 years. You could have been almost sentenced to 50 years, if you threatened to harm your student again, and lost your job forever because of what you did.
Your former student had the worst birthday of his whole entire life, because of you, along with your teacher staff, three of your students, one of my sister, his grandparents, and his parents.
And honey, I'm sorry for what I did to one of my students. It's because he was the worst student at my school, causing trouble and destruction to my school, and I allow child abuse, because bad students need to be taught a lesson for what they did. I promise, I will never do it anymore, ever again.
It's too late for apologies, Mom. Plus, don't apologize to us. You should be apologizing to your former student Caillou for what you did to him. You blew your chances for everyone here. Everyone hates you for what you've done to your former student for child abuse and help his parents with his birthday punishment day. You blew it big time.
And yes, you will never do it again, because you along with your teacher employee have been sentenced here for 25 years, so you'll never harm your former student ever again. You should realize that allowing child abuse at your school is very illegal. You should help students with their problems, not child abuse. You know what? We're done with you. I'm writing a divorce paper and you will never be my wife ever again.
Yeah. We don't want to see you anymore for what you've done to your former student. Since you and your employees are sentenced here for 25 years, Caillou grandparents for 80 years, one of your students are sentenced to juvenile detention center, and will be attending community service. That goes for my sister, Mr. Cherry, for the rest of his life in jail. Mario and Luigi are also sentenced for rest of their lives.
And his parents are executed after their punishment day, for his son paid back in revenge for abusing him 24/7. That's it. We had enough. We are leaving right now. We don't want to see you anymore for what you did to the poor boy. We're done with you. Permanently. You will never be my wife anymore. You're being divorced forever.
Goodbye forever, Mom. We must get going to meet my sister at her jail cell, and I will never see your face ever again.
Oh great. It's my husband.
Miss Martin, how could you help Caillou parents with his birthday punishment day? You know that's not how teachers are supposed to work. He may have crashed into our house with a sled, but that doesn't give you the rights to abuse him. I heard the entire conversation of what you did to your former student.
You know what? I had enough of you. I'm writing a divorce paper, and I'll never see you again. Goodbye. I must get going.
Oh no, my ex-husband and my son are now furious at me for what I did to Caillou. And I'm getting divorced by my husband for what I've done. I knew they were going to show up here, from all the way from Go City.
Same here. After 25 years, we will become homeless by then, or be in a nursing home. It's okay, Miss Clementine, I'm still here for you. Far from more worse, Boris and Doris have been executed after their punishment day as Kalo payback and revenge.
I feel so sorry for them. It's just so terrible. It's a good thing that we're cellmates together.
I can't believe that this had to happen. I can't believe I'm sentenced to the rest of my life in prison for what I have done to Caillou. That is so not fair. Even worse, my brother Alan and my nephew Warren Cook visit me in my jail cell and disown me and kick me out of his family for what I've done to Caillou. I watched the full other event of his parents getting a punishment day and executed. It's just so terrible and it made me so sad. I bet his parents had the worst punishment day ever. I wish I could save them, but there's nothing I can do. Since I'm stuck in jail for the rest of my life, I won't make it for the rest of my life in prison. When I turn 65, I will go into a nursing home. Why didn't they sentence Caillou for what he has done? He committed terrorists and put his teacher in a volcano. Everyone hates me for what I have done to Caillou on his birthday. There's got to be another way out of prison. I can't let that ball brat get away with his actions.
Hey,
Don't even think about escaping jail. If you ever think about escaping jail, there will be more consequences. Don't even risk yourself of getting sentenced to death. Anyways, I must get going.
I can't believe we're in juvenile detention center, and we'll be facing community service. And later, we'll be homeless, when we're adults for what we have done to Caillou. That is really not fair. I don't want to live in the street without food or water. It would be so hard when I'm 18. Caillou is the one who deserved this torture. My life is officially ruined thanks to Caillou. But people hate us, and the ones who ruined Caillou life. I'm so scared to be an adult, and be homeless.
I agree, Sarah. Same goes to you. I also can't believe I've been sentenced to juvenile detention center as well. Caillou should be the one in prison, not us. We don't deserve it.
To be honest, I literally regret helping Caillou parents for his birthday punishment day. I should have known it was a bad idea for me to do it.
But Clementine, you did the right thing to help Caillou parents for his birthday punishment day, along with us, and he deserves it for being a troublemaker and causing trouble to us.
But look at myself, I'm in juvenile detention center, and I will be attending community service. I will not be good enough to be a kid and a grown woman because of what I did to Caillou, and everyone hates me, including you guys, for what we did to Caillou. I blew it for it for myself.
We know that everyone hates us for what we did to Caillou. You didn't blew it. You've done the right thing, cause he deserves this torture on his birthday.
Well, I did not done the right thing. I committed a crime, and ruined everything for myself. I don't want to talk about it anymore.
Clementine, your brother and your dad are here to see you.
Oh no. I bet they're really angry at me, for what I did to Caillou. Hey Dad and Billy, are you really angry at me?
Angry? No. We are extremely furious with you, Clementine. Billy and I can't believe you were sentenced to juvenile detention center, and be attending community service, for helping Kalo's parents, along with your two classmates next to you, one of Kalo's grandparents, your teacher, the vice principal and your mother, for his birthday punishment day, by shooting him with a gun, destroying his room with gasoline and a gun. What the hell is wrong with you? Words cannot describe how furious we are of you. For what you did to your classmate.
Our dad is right. Do you realize that's child abuse? Now thanks to you, along with your classmate, and others, including Caillou parents. He had the worst birthday ever in his life. You seriously had to do that so insanely to him? And look at yourself. You're in juvenile detention center until you turn into adult. My dad did not raise you the way you did to him. He doesn't deserve to be child abuse on his birthday. You literally had to ruin it.
Billy and Dad, please, I am really sorry for what I did to Caillou. I know you heard my reasons back at school. I promise, I will never do this to Caillou ever again. Please forgive me.
Don't give us your apology. Apologize to Kalo. For what you did to him on his birthday, you're the one who did this to him, not us.
But Dad, I don't think he will accept my apology. I know he will deny my apology big time.
Well then, it's your fault for what you've done to him on his birthday. I bet he's furious at you, for helping his parents, for his birthday punishment day, along with others.
Yeah. And because of all of that, you are sentenced to juvenile detention center until you're 18 years old. That goes for your two classmates, Leo and Sarah. Your mother and teacher, has been sentenced to 25 years in jail. The vice principal has been sentenced to the rest of his life in prison. That goes for Mario and Luigi. Fred Jones has been sentenced to 60 years in jail. And Kalo's grandparents have been sentenced to 80 years in jail. And we saw the live event of Kalo parents having their punishment day, and have been executed for what they have done to their son 24/7. Everyone hates you for what you did to him. He will have a better life now, since his parents are dead, including you, along with your two classmates, your mother, his grandparents, the vice principal, and your teachers anymore. You know what? We are done with you.
From today, you are being disowned and kicked out of our family for what you did to your classmate.
No, please don't disown me, Dad and Billy. I will never do this to Caillou ever again. Can I please still be in your family?
No, you caused our life in jeopardy. Right now, I had apologized to Caillou for what you done to him, and I thought about disowning you.
For what you two did to him, it's already too late for this. Everyone hates you for what you have done to Kalo. We are so done with you big time.
That's right, Clementine. My dad is filling the disowned papers here. Then after that, we'll be heading all the way back home to Go City. Well, since you will be turning 18 after your sentence, goodbye forever, Clementine. We are so done with you permanently. Have fun being juvenile detention center. And without a family, we are leaving now.
No, I can't believe my dad is disowning me for what I did to Caillou. This is all of my fault. Why did I help Caillou's parents for his birthday punishment day? I screwed up myself big time. I ruined my own life. And now everyone hates me for what I did to Caillou. Wah 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 wah. I blew it big time.
Clementine, it wasn't your fault. It was all Caillou's fault for getting us in.
Don't touch me. Leave me alone.
But Clementine, you can't be alone. You are in a juvenile detention center cell.
Oh, then don't talk to me until I feel like talking to you again.
I can't believe that this had to happen. Our lives are officially ruined. Everyone hates us for what we did to Caillou. And now we're in juvenile detention center until we're 18 years old. We will be homeless by then.
I know, Sarah. I feel so scared that my parents are going to yell at me when they arrive at our jail cell. Same goes with you.
Oh boy, this is terrifying. Besides, what can go wrong?